is my stage and the sun is my spotlight. Joshua Taya. This year may have stopped us from being together on stage, but it certainly hasn't stopped us from doing what we love and what expresses us the best. Because the aim of art is not to represent the outward appearance of things, but the inward significance. With this thought, I would like to welcome you all to Anandam 2020. Even though this year may have been unprecedented, it surely hasn't stopped us from bringing about the best in us. As for all of us, this year was full of self-discoveries. And today, we bring to you performances which are a result of sheer hard work, persistence, and our zeal of self-expression.
Namaskar. Good evening, parents. So here we are with Anandam 2021. When everything has changed, could Anandam not have done that? So, the endeavor here is that our signature programs, as you have experienced Fankar, award ceremony of 6 to 10, and now Anandam, that none of the essence is lost while we are presenting it to you. I think, needless to say, it has been hard for the art teachers to teach performing arts, to teach visual arts through this digital medium. How far does the teacher go so that her footwork is visible? How big is her room in her house so that all her moves and mudras are visible and evident to the children so that they can pick it up? They've also faced challenges of low attendance. They face some challenges when there have been assessments, the children have just not turned up for a week prior. So, keeping the sense of joy alive, this is not the true version of Shiv Nadar School Anandam, but the flavor, the core, the soul remains the same. I hope you enjoy it as it unfolds. Theater, dance, music, and a new way of presenting to you the gallery of work that our children have done in painting, in art. Sit back and have a good time. My thanks to all the teachers and to you for supporting them, dressing them up for recordings, multiple edits, and then the teachers stitching it together. What skills we have learned, and I think they'll stay with us for life. And congratulations, children. Sit back and enjoy the premiere today. Thank you.
Welcome all. We, the students of AHA 6 to 8, are going to perform Tanda. Shiva is used to express his grief and anger through Tanda. In this dance, gods show their expressions while dancing. When Shiva dances, all heavenly bodies respond. Saraswati is said to be playing the veena. Indra is said to be playing the flute. Brahma is said to keep rhythm. Lakshmi Devi is said to be singing. Vishnu is said to be playing mridanga. And all other deities stand around watching the dance.
Ta-ta-ta! Thay, thay, tadhigad tak thay. Thay, thay, tadhigad tak thay. Thay, 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 tadhigad tak, tadhigad tak, tadhigad tak thay. Thay, tadhigad tak, tadhigad tak, tadhigad tak thay. Thay, ta tham ta ki ta ta ka. Thagad yam thay, thay, ta tham ta ki ta ta ka. Thagad yam thay, thay, ta ha ta di na muta, ta ha ta di ni thay.
Hello everyone, my name is Yashvi Mida and I stand before you today to welcome you to Anandam 2021, grade 6 to 8. This year, we started our AHA basket with Ms. Jasmine Sajdev to embark on a journey of fun modules, like our first one about clowning, in which we ran off to make clown noses out of whatever was available at home. We also played some games relating to theatre, which were surprisingly easier on an online platform. Now, at the end of the year, we started to recollect all our skills and concepts that we learned in the entire year to devise a piece created, scripted, and acted by us, the students. So please sit back and we hope you enjoy the show. Did that for you. Guys, stop speaking the language of the dead. Speak English. They were just saying hi.
Hi.
Who are you to interrupt the conversation?
Did you read the letter I sent you?
What letter?
Oh, so you think you're too busy to read my letters?
I'm trying to advance the future of math and science. And you think that being busy is the bad thing?
Calm down, everybody. You are the great scientist Einstein?
Yes, I am.
Oh, you're the Jewish girl who was writing a diary in World War II?
Yep.
Freedom is not given, it's taken.
Oh, Subhash, a popular demand for the movie?
Which movie? Are you a director?
Hi, everybody.
Did I invite you?
Yes, you did. I received a letter.
Okay, guys, we all are very different. But what binds us together?
We are very well educated.
But will a movie about education be interesting? Any other ideas?
We all know about freedom and many of us fought for it too.
Yeah, that's a great idea. Let's work on that. Come on, guys.
Wow, what a game. No. Whatever. I won the last time and will win this time with this card.
Yeah. What happened, Raja?
Wait. Where is my plus four? I'm sure George has taken it. George, you thief! How dare you?
I'm the great George Washington, the first president of America. I'm the one who built it with my hard work. People love me. Will I do it?
Neither a borrower or nor a lender we come from.
There we go again.
Will you ever stop quoting?
Okay. Sorry, guys. Just give him the card.
Okay. Liam.
So, after all this confusion and stuff, I chose to put them in three different groups with Shakespeare in a room with me. Let's see what happens with them.
Bhash, Raja, anybody here? Oh my god. Guys, they have locked me in this breakout room and are not letting me out. Just because my mic wasn't working. I can't, in this breakout room, there's no option for ask for help. I can't even call them. Just to tell them that my mic is working. It's just so rude, guys. They just locked me in a breakout room just because my mic wasn't working. You could just politely say that the mic is not working. But no, they locked me. What should I do? I can't even chat with anyone because it's just me in the breakout room. I have to go out. And if I click the leave room, then it doesn't show. Like it says the host has blocked coming to the main screen. What should I do? Anybody?
Hello, Rajaji and Rani. How are you guys doing?
We are doing fine. How are you?
Yeah, I am fine too. What are we doing here, really?
So, according to Kubrick, we are talking about the conditions of the Indian society in present India.
So, basically, in India, child labor is restricted, but some poor families send their children to work.
Yeah, they want to earn money from their children.
They send their children as chimney sweepers because children can go in only narrow chimneys.
They send them as labor and many more things like selling veggies and cleaning people's houses and vehicles.
But isn't it illegal here?
Yes, but I have also heard that poor families send their children to work in London too.
Yeah, these things work in London, but it's completely wrong.
I don't understand. We gave our lives for the country, got our independence, but these things have not gone away.
At least Sati was done away with.
Basic respect regarding women seems to be missing.
Even though India got its independence, we haven't really been free.
Hello.
The fundamental rights placed by the Constitution weren't taken seriously. Take my own example, the Nazis considered Jews as the inferior race compared to the Aryan race.
Speaking of racism, it's a worldwide thing which exists everywhere. Even I experienced something of that sort known as apartheid. Countries in Europe and America still practice heavy racism.
But didn't your country gain its independence?
Yes, we did, but racism did not vanish overnight. Racism is still prevalent in the country.
When World War II ended, Nazism was quickly eradicated.
That's not true. Evil like that does not go away so quickly.
Exactly. A very similar kind of discrimination which I went through and fought against is discrimination based on caste. I belong to the lowest caste known as the Shudras, and this whole system helped in making my and my caste's people's life miserable every day, and nothing is solved yet.
I am also a Jew. The world would go into hiding, like Anne. Because Hugh shall not be named, wanted to suppress his rights, I lost 5 years of my work. If he had not tried to do it, I could have done much more in my life.
Indeed, the abuse of fundamental rights impacted us majorly and put us in unfair conditions.
Yes, I also remember that George Washington had slaves. Something you want to say, George Washington?
Slavery had not been banned. And besides, we had been grown up thinking that African Americans weren't our equals. So don't blame me entirely. And there was no rule against it in the Constitution too.
Okay. Whatever. You could have done so much better. I'm disappointed indeed. After all these years, I believed that casteist and racist behavior would vanish from the face of the earth.
Did a constant effort go in vain?
Is there any consciousness left in our society anymore?
Oh, hey, William Shakespeare, good to see you.
Or not to see you. I've heard a lot about your work.
It seems like everyone has. Who are you again?
Why are you speaking in a female voice? You were speaking in a male voice before.
Well, there's no known identity of me, and hence, nothing about my identity can be fixed. Sometimes I'm a man, sometimes I'm a woman, and sometimes I'm even a group of people. It keeps changing.
Okay, cool. I'm a movie director and I also have written some stuff. Like you, so a movie is basically like a play on a screen. So it
I
is...
I know about you, the arts family. So you're the one making this movie.
Yes, Bill. I mean, sir. I mean, William. I mean, ma'am. I'm hoping that it is a hit, like most of my work. Really looking forward to see your views on fundamental rights. I was thinking that we could discuss about fundamental rights of actors and directors, since we are both renowned creators and artists and have a lot in common.
Sure. Sounds good. Share your views.
So basically what I wanted to talk about was, actually I'm confused about it. I've been criticized by people for the treatment meted out to an actor, but I did it to make sure that the film doesn't suffer.
But acting is also an art. Shouldn't actors also have the creative freedom to make sure that they contribute in their own way to the play, or in your case, the film?
Yes, but I completely disagree. Because as a director, it is our job to ensure that perfection exists. There is something I want to say. The film is my vision. They agreed to join my vision.
But Stanley, there is no complete perfection in any art. Imperfection is part of the art.
Agreed, sir, but When actors are employed, a director has certain expectations. He pushes the actor so that the director's view reaches the audience properly. In the end, it is the director with the ultimate power.
Stanley, this is disappointing. If you knew about my works, you would know that all my plays have a central theme. You cannot misuse your power. You shouldn't misuse your creative license as a director.
Well, they're not your slaves, Stanley. A play is what an entire team creates. A sweeper who sweeps the auditorium is equally responsible for the play as actors, light designers, backstage crew, or even the director.
You want to talk about your fundamental rights, but you can't even grasp the basic concept of leadership. Hey, Stan, I can't hear you. You're on mute, Stan.
So, I hope you had a great time watching how miserable I was trying to get these important figures, champions of free speech and freedom, to come and get together to make a film on fundamental rights. Well, Bill was right. I might have been too strong on my cast and crew. Well, as you could see, the first room just swallowed in pity and the second room just became even more angry about it. And someone from my room just switched off my audio. If I had taken away the freedom of speech, then maybe I could have completed the film I wanted. But would it be worth it? Maybe I should be more accommodating. Can you listen to this, Noel, sir? Can you?
Have learned so many things during this pandemic through online classes. We learned many tukras and tihais. We even constructed our own moves on Dhyan Shlokam. Dhyan is a Sanskrit word which means meditation and Shlokam means prayer. So basically it means meditation prayer. Dhyan Shlokam is also a very popular shloka in praise of Lord Shiva, also known as Nataraja. We even created our own choreography on Vande Mataram song for Independence Day. Overall, we are so grateful that we had the opportunity to learn Kathak while being at home.
Everyone, and welcome to Anandam 6-8. Our performance emerged from the themes of identity and differences and has been devised by the students themselves. In this process, we explored various aspects of playwriting, building scenes through improvisation and voice and character. Additionally, adapting to the changes of COVID, we have tried to build a performance suited for the online meet. Hope you enjoy the show.
Dear Diary, it's me again. Well, you know, I have this bad habit of changing my color all the time. Some of the people even call me the color changing thing. I can't figure out who I really am. In the morning, a child threw water at me to see if I go transparent. And at around 3, a small kid almost drove his bicycle on me because I blended with the grass so well. I'm not sure what's going to happen next.
What's up?
I'm fine. How are you?
I'm good too.
How'd you know school?
It's fine.
And how are the cafeterias?
Big but dirty.
And what about the sports field?
The sports field is very uneven.
And what about the classrooms?
The classrooms are fine. What do I say?
And have you made any friends yet?
अरे मैं अभी तो आया हूँ और मैं प्रश्न तो थोड़ी करने आया हूँ मैं तुमसे बात करने आया हूँ।
ओके ठीक है। Why are you so snappy?
तुम्हें पता है मुझे I had the strangest dream yesterday.
What was it?
It was of a chameleon.
Chameleon?
Yes, that even inspired me to write a masterpiece. Would you like to hear it?
Why not? The offer is accepted.
Caught in a flood, a chameleon struggled and reached a dense forest which was not its home. The place was quite strange to him. The rocks, the bushes, and the trees, and especially the animals. Soon he discovered that the animals weren't too friendly.
Oh, there's the chameleon going by. What a foolish little creature.
Ooh, you are so tiny. I could toss you around like a fruit.
Oh, are you supposed to scare me with those big eyes? I'm terrified.
Ha ha, jokes apart, you all have to do as I say.
But the thing that they made fun of the most was the color-changing ability of the chameleon. Every animal stayed one color, but the chameleon kept changing shades. If the chameleon was near grass, it would turn green. If it was near water, then it would turn either blue or transparent. And if near mud, it would turn a muddy brown.
Does this chameleon remind you of someone?
Remind me of someone? Who?
Think, use your brain.
I can't. Tell me now.
Okay, I'll tell you after the story.
No, right now.
Just go ahead. I'll tell you after the story. Okay, go ahead. What happens okay. Next?
Okay.
The chameleon tried everything it could do fit in. It even consulted the wise donkey of the forest.
Oh, wise donkey, what do I do to fit in?
Oh, dear chameleon. First, you have to stop this pesky color changing business.
But I can't.
Why? Why you can't be like the rest? With normal color?
I don't know.
Well, not to fret my chameleon child. I know just what to do.
What? I'll do anything.
10 days from now, at the stroke of midnight, you have to bathe in goat's milk and chicken feathers.
Goat's milk and chicken feathers?
You question my wisdom?
No. I'll try it, oh wise dog.
All the donkey's advice did was help the chameleon turn into a milky white color. So this time, the chameleon tried the rabbit.
What should I do?
Hey man, it is so easy.
What, really?
Yes, all you need is a balanced diet of carrots and you'll be fit as me.
A
That's it. And where do I get the carrots?
You'll find the carrots in a farm nearby. The carrots over there are very delicious.
The chameleon tried the sloth. Finally tried the fox.
Oh, hello, Rainbow Maid.
Oh, hi, Fox. Can I ask you for a favor?
What do I get in return, huh? Okay, I'll help you if you help me find a prey.
Okay,
so sounds good. Deal accepted.
So what should I do?
What should you do? Huh? See you next time when you have some prey for me.
The chameleon looked here and there and everywhere for prey big enough for the fox.
The chameleon couldn't change his colors and lived sadly ever after.
What? That's it?
Yes.
What a bad ending.
Oh my god.
So that's how you end up?
Me?
Yes. You are needed school and the chameleon is needed the forest. The parallels are obvious. Oh god.
What?
Can you at least change the ending?
How do you like to have it?
The chameleon is accepted into the folds of all the animals and lives happily ever after.
No! The chameleon falls into a pit and dies of starvation.
No! The chameleon becomes the king of the jungle, overthrowing the lion, and becomes a color-changing fashion icon.
No! The chameleon becomes depressed, doesn't talk to anyone, and spends the rest of his life in a cave, where after some time, it is eaten by a bat.
No! He lives a happy life!
No, for the millionth time! Tales of chameleon misery are told through the forest!
Listen.
What?
You need a better ending.
No, I don't.
Hey.
Hi.
Oh, how's it going?
Way better than before.
That's great.
Yeah, I even made some friends.
Nice.
Some people were really nice.
I told you so.
And also, I found a new ending to the chameleon story.
Really? What is it?
Yes. One day, when the chameleon was lying in a pit, it noticed another chameleon. What do you think?
It's nice, but I still prefer the fashion icon ending.
I don't think that we're going to reach an agreement.
So what do we do?
Let's ask them.
You mean the audience?
Yes.
This has been a difficult year, from dealing with connectivity issues to working with limited art material. This year couldn't be more challenging. But is that all 2020 was? What do you think, Shreya?
Well, Krishangi, that's true, but I'm sure you would agree that conducting virtual art classes gave us a fresh and dynamic perspective to visual arts. It allowed us to think differently and develop visual vocabularies motivated by regular lived spaces and experiences.
I couldn't agree more. We have been able to use the technologies available to us to involve our classes online. With art classes, we took the opportunity to retreat within our homes and hone our skills of sketching and painting, taking inspiration from regular lived spaces. In fact, in a strange way, this allowed us to find our inner qualities and abilities.
You are so right, Siona. Limited within our home spaces, painting from memory and imagination offered a whole new meaning to us. Do you remember how many wonderful projects we undertook and such varied genres of art we dabbled in this year, such as collage, still life, figurative composition, etc.?
Indeed, we have been able to cultivate a platform for dialogue surrounding art and ideas. We even tried our hand at many global art trends, such as reinterpreting great masters' painting during this pandemic. Now that we have learned fresher ways of looking and having engaged in newer methods and techniques, these aspects have become central to our understanding of art and the world around it.
And not to forget, art helped us calm and relax ourselves when there was so much of turmoil going in the outside world. It helped us overcome the despair of the pandemic.
Culminating this unusual but pertinent year, we are trying something new. This year, we are showcasing our artworks on Instagram.
What better way to reach in the digital platform? We are delighted to present the two baskets of AHA within visual arts for grade 6 to 10. To view the display, please click on the Instagram link mentioned in the description box. So gear up to see our beautiful and vibrant paintings. Thank you.
My sincere greetings to everyone. I am a student of Kathak Basket, and me and my friends have been attending our Kathak classes online due to the current scenario. It has its drawbacks, like not being able to meet our friends and our teacher, but we have all learned a lot and we grew better together. And today, here we are. We learned our Anandam performance through videos that our teacher sent to us. And we shall be presenting a dance performance on a very beautiful bhajan, Vaishnav Janto. Vaishnav Janto is written in the 15th century by the poet Narsingh Mehta. The bhajan speaks about the ideas, the mentality, and the life of a Vaishnav Jana, which means the follower of Vaishnavism. It was also one of Gandhiji's favorite bhajan, and it has a very soothing rhythm. I hope you enjoy our performance. Thank you.
Faridabad, there are several annual occasions we hold close to our hearts, and Anandam definitely makes it to the top of that list. It's not only a culmination of our AHA Arts program, but it's also a celebration of our year-long journeys together. It is my privilege to have been given the opportunity to propose a vote of thanks on this special occasion. 2020 was definitely a challenging year for all of us, but it also taught us some great virtues. Resilience, adaptability, connectedness, and resourcefulness. And this year's Anandam is shining proof that we can do it when we set our hearts and our minds to it. On behalf of the Shiv Nadar School fraternity, I would like to extend a humble thanks to all the students, teachers, parents, support staff, and our principal Anju ma'am, who made this all possible. Together we can, and together we will.